I'm Robert Froemke. I'm an assistant professor here at NYU Medical. I run a research lab in the Skirball Institute, and I'm in the departments of otolaryngology and neuroscience and physiology. I've been here about 4 years now, and in general we study neuroplasticity, basically how it is that brains change in response to experience in the world, how it is we learn new information, and how those changes in our brains allow us to change our performance and our behaviors. For most of my childhood, I wanted to be an artist. In fact, I went to art school right after high school. But really, at a fundamental level, I think that science and art making are fundamentally the same kind of thing. We're pushing the limits of media. We're trying to figure out sort of what's possible and kind of to expand the limits of knowledge and our experiences in that way. In a word, then, what we do is communicate. You know, if we toil away in the lab here for weeks, for years, it doesn't matter unless we can get out there and communicate those results effectively to our collaborators, to our friends, to our scientific rivals who are going to push our limits in terms of our business, but also to our family and friends and the greater public to really help keep us going as a field, as part of the culture. But doing science itself is very anxiety-producing. Really, one of my main jobs is to help, you know, quench the anxiety about collecting new results. Because a new result is very exciting, but it's also very scary, because no one's ever seen this before. I think that one of the main jobs we have as scientists is to be mentors, is to really look down at the incoming generation and get them excited about what we do. I mean, my favorite scientists are my mentors. Really, one of my first days in graduate school, there was a dusty old microscope that young Dan, my PhD advisor, and myself, we brushed it off, we fired it up. Young hadn't done it herself in years, and she sat down and, like a natural, got it to work. And then she taught me how to do it. And I put an electrode in a neuron, and we turned on an oscilloscope, the green traces glowing in the darkness of the room. And when I first saw the action potentials, the individual spikes that a neuron was generating, this is the language the brain uses to communicate, these very fast changes in voltage. When I saw that on the oscilloscope, it blew me away. It really changed my life. I knew exactly that it was the kind of science I had to do. And still to this day, this is what we do in the lab. But certainly, the core of science is passion. Without that passion and that drive to really be creative and to break with convention, which is what doing science is all about, without that passion, I think there's no point in being a scientist. Honestly, it's a job full of failure. Most of our ideas are mostly wrong. It's just by this slow iterative process of motivating the next generation and really enabling them to discover what it is that we got right and what we got wrong, and having them test that and probe that and really challenge our work, and sometimes in a really personal way. That's the way science progresses. Thank you.